Gold hanging on to advances as a dollar dropped to a fresh two-year low. Does gold's explosive rally still have some more to go, or could the precious metal be on the verge of a technical trend reversal? Joining us now, Sabrin Chowdry, Senior Commodities Analyst of Fitch Solutions. Hi, Sabrin. Thank you for joining us.
Hi, thanks for having me.
So dollar-linked assets, including anti-dollars like gold, for example, have had a remarkable run in recent months. And some say that, you know, gold has even taken a life of its own, from $1,500 per ounce 12 months ago to a record $2,000 per ounce. Your 2020 to 2021 forecast, though, is showing a $1,850 per ounce. So you are seeing a pullback?
Well, prices in the year to date have averaged only close to $1,700 an ounce. So my $1,850 an ounce for the rest of for the entire year this year actually means that I am bullish going forward. I expect prices to go up a little higher over the coming 4 months, which will lead us to that particular average of $1,850. So no, I don't see a strong trend reversal in gold, but there will be occasional volatile periods. There might be some occasional pullbacks in gold, but then the trend is definitely upwards from now.
Mm-hmm. Because, you know, everybody's asking, are we basically saying that gold will need more bad news to prosper from here? But on the one hand, we're all optimistic that the worst is over already. So what else could drive gold?
Well, gold thrives on uncertainty and risk, so it doesn't necessarily have to be bad news. We just need uncertainty, which will support sustained risk of sentiment amongst investors and incentivize the investment into safe haven assets like gold. So when you say the worst is likely behind us, yes, the worst is likely behind us in terms of the economic shock that the world received this year due to COVID-19. But going forward, the economic recovery is set to be bumpy and slow, and the speed of recovery will vary amongst countries. So there is still uncertainty in terms of economic shock. In the COVID sphere, yes, the number of COVID-19 cases are plateauing throughout the world, but there is still the absence of an effective vaccine. Thirdly, there is a myriad of global uncertainties that still persist. So there are U.S.-China tensions. Let's not forget the U.S. presidential elections coming up in November. Also, global bond yields globally are at historic lows, and central banks are all adopting an accommodative monetary policy. So all these will incentivize investment into gold and continue to support gold prices. Mm-hmm.
But Sabrin, when you look at supply and demand in the great gold bull market, is it the ETF demand, the more speculative demand that's driving it? Or are you seeing fundamental demand, say, from jewelry companies or central banks?
So fundamental demand is not the main driver of prices this year. I would say most of the boost in demand is coming from ETF purchases. Yes, we have had quite high central bank demand from Russia, Turkey, China, but it's not the main driver. The main driver is ETFs. For instance, in the first half of this year, the ETF purchases, gold ETF purchases, have amounted to close to $40 billion, which is way past the full year record set in 2009. So the driver of gold this year is definitely ETFs, not fundamentals.
And is that a good thing or a bad thing? Because ETFs, demand from ETFs could mean speculative demand.
Well, it's not a good thing or a bad thing. I mean, there's still money coming into the markets. Mm-hmm. There is still some sort of stimulation. So for metals, whether it's gold or any other metals in the world, their prices are driven by both fundamentals as well as investor sentiment and speculative demand. So I don't think there is anything bad as long as there is money flowing into the economy.
Mm-hmm. And let's talk about seasonality, because for commodities, we look at price patterns. And according to Bloomberg data, you know, since 1975, gold's price gains always come in the months of January and September. On average, according to data, gold jumps around 1.8% every September for various reasons. But basically, there's a lot of restocking happening in anticipation of holidays and and gift-giving events. Do you think that, you know, that's going to be true this year, that we're going to see gold jump again this September? Because right now gold, the spot price for gold is trading at $1,946 per ounce.
Well, in past years, you're right, we have seen some boost to gold prices in January and September. The main reasons behind this is because we have the Chinese New Year holiday in late January to February that increases the demand for gold, fundamental demand. There's also Diwali in October, which is why there is a boost to gold prices around September. But like I said, this year, fundamental demand is not going to be the main driver of gold. And as well, jewelry demand is at historic lows right now because of recession and lower spending power. So this year, if you're speaking about the remaining 4 months of the year, I think the main driver will be the U.S. presidential elections and the uncertainties revolving around it, because there is a chance that, you know, the election could be disputed. So that is the main risk which will drive gold prices in the coming 4 months of the year, definitely not jewelry demand. And also, there are also the other drivers that I've mentioned, number of COVID-19 cases, mm-hmm. a vaccine, low bond yields, the U.S. dollar, geopolitical tensions, the uneven global economic recovery. So these factors remain this year, not seasonality.
Okay, on that note, thank you very much, Sabrin, for joining us this morning.
Thanks for having me.